buzzsaw. And then the plane goes, so that they cross each other at 90 degrees. That gives you a really kind of cool shape. It's neat because it looks like a buzzsaw still, kind of stretched out from the side. And then instead of just being a line, it creates an X to the front. So that's what atomics are good for, you know, kind of a three-dimensional appeal. And you could point those kind of down, so instead of them being at two diagonal angles like this, you move it to where they're two horizontal planes, but crossing at 90 degrees. That's, like that thing. And then this will come in handy later. This is basically a box atomic for buzzsaw. And you can do the opposite variation, so instead of the buzzsaw being parallel to your arms, the buzzsaw can go perpendicular. So that's another variation of the box buzzsaw. And you can do all of these buzzsaws in forward and reverse. And you can also do them in, instead of split time, same time. So the same time, parallel, same time, diagonal buzzsaw, same time, box. You can do those in reverse as well. The cool thing about learning the diagonal is it's a perfect transition from a box to the diagonal, and then you tip it into a horizontal. So here we have a horizontal buzzsaw, the other horizontal buzzsaw. A horizontal buzzsaw can orient to you in two different ways, straight on like a buzzsaw, or you can turn it and just make a reel in the wall, and you still have one in horizontal. Turning 360s and stuff like that. So those are the basic atomic buzzsaws.